Hello friends, welcome to 9th lesson on batch scripting. In this lesson, we will talk about local and global variables. If you guys haven't seen my previous video on batch scripting, I will highly recommend you guys to go and check that out. The link will be in the description. So today we are discussing about local and global variables. In any programming language, there is an option to mark variables as having some sort of scope. Normally, variables have a global scope, can be accessed anywhere from a program, whereas local scope variables have a defined boundary in which they can be accessed. In DOS scripting also, there is a definition for locally and globally scoped variables. By default, variables are global to our entire command prompt session. Call the setLocal command to make variables local to the scope of your script. So let's see how's that done. So let's create the basic structure, echo off, to stop the echoing, pause to hold the screen. Let's define the global variable, let's say 5. Let's define the local variables now. Set, let's use var and use the value suppose 5. Slash a to hold the numeric value, use the same variable, and I want to add 3 in that. So I want to add 3 in 5. So let's print that. Let's print the value of var and also print the value of global variable so that it will give us the idea that it's accessible all across the program and the scope of local variable, and save that. Create a bat executable file. So this variable should print 5 plus 3, 8 in the output, and this should print 5. So let's see that. 8 has been printed and 5 has been printed. That seems good. What happens if we define this variable outside the local scope? Since this has been destroyed, so let's see what happens. So in this case, nothing will happen. So it will just give you an option that says echo is off on this. So let's see, echo is off because the scope of this variable has been destroyed. And this was a local variable and we destroyed the scope here, so nothing is inside the variable. So that was one thing. There is one more concept, that's environment variables. If you have a variable that would be used across batch files, then it's always preferable to use environment variables. Once the environment variable is defined, it can be accessed via percentage sign. So let me show you environment variables. So open that, go to environment variables. Let's say I want to access driver data, okay? So let me open the command prompt, write the command echo. Whatever you have to write, you have to write in double quotes. Driver data, and the output will show driver data directory, which will depend from system to system. So that was all for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. In the next video, we will talk about string in batch script. Till then, stay tuned, stay connected. Thank you for watching this video. Bye-bye.